Today I'm going to demonstrate the use of a seam guide on a vintage machine. This is a Frister and Rossmann transverse shuttle from about 1937. And the seam guide is here, I haven't attached it yet. And the thing with old machines is that there are no measurements either on the bed of the machine, on these plates, or on the seam guide to give you any indication of the exact measurement of the seam allowance you are giving. So what I have done is I've just knocked the camera, and I've also got a piece of paper here which has been folded, and on the folded edge I've measured in 1/4 of an inch, because today I want to do 1/4 of an inch seam allowances. Now I'm going to put this folded edge, raise the needle, put this folded edge and put the line directly down the opening in the foot, and I'm going to put the seam guide there against the folded edge of the paper and screw it into position. Now these screws go right into the bed of the machine, and it's very useful with this machine. It has 2 screw holes, so it keeps the seam guide very firmly in place. I've now screwed the seam guide firmly into position, and I'm going to run the machine along this paper. There's no thread in the needle, but I'm going to run it along the line. And you can see that the seam guide is taking the paper along that line very neatly. Now it's always useful to do this, because if for any reason whilst I was on a project where I'd already decided on the seam allowance and I needed to remove the seam guide, I have this piece of paper ready and I can line the seam guide again with this piece of paper. Now I'm going to thread the machine and I'm going to start doing some strips, which I'll then use for patchwork. Now I've got 2 strips together, one slightly darker than the other, and I'm going to sew them. And the easy thing with strips is you can use your fingers as a guide also. The middle finger, you can see, is just holding the strip flat, and the fingers on either side are just guiding each side as it goes through. You have to line them up again every now and again when you see that they're falling out of line, and carry on. There we have a lovely straight seam allowance of 1/4 of an inch. And now we'll do another pair of strips. Check every now and again to make sure they're laying flat on top of each other. There, done. I've now ironed the strips with the seam pointing towards the darker strip. Both the strips were, the individual strips were 2 inches wide, so I've now cut some pieces 2 inches across and I'm going to put them together and make little 4 patches. And I'll chain piece them, in other words, just feed them through as a production line. So I'm having light colours put against dark colours and we'll start chain piecing. And you'll see that I'm holding the seams in place so that they join evenly. And you can just feed the next one in when the first one's reached the back of the foot. And the last one coming up. So I've now made 4 little 4 patches, they're in a string, I'll go and iron them. I've now ironed the 4 patches and we have 4 nice little 4 patches ready for my next project. And because I'm going to need different colours, I'm going to do another cut of strips.